today's lesson, it's about trusting in God. It is about trusting in God. If you can remember so well, I took you through something different last time, and that was people we trust for our safety. We mentioned some few people we put our trust in for us to live safely. We heard the church leaders, family members, teachers, we heard friends, and finally I mentioned the police. But today, one person remained. I did not mention this person called God because I wanted to teach him so special. And that is why today I want to take you through trusting in God. Imagine of this scenario. You have a friend. You are playing with a friend outside or there at home or even back at school. Maybe you are playing with a friend this type of game. You ask your friend or you go and tie your friend's eyes. You blindfold your friend. Then you ask your friend to maybe go and pick something or to walk a given distance. Maybe you want your friend to walk a given distance, maybe from where you are up to somewhere. But this friend cannot walk alone. This friend tells you, or you provide a friend, another friend to lead, or another person to lead this friend towards or to that point you want your friend to reach. So you find that this friend who has been blindfolded is taken or is led by another person. Remember, this person who is leading this blindfolded friend should be walking so slowly. Why so slowly? To be so careful, because the other person is not seeing. So this friend has to walk slowly and slowly, and at that same point, the person or that friend who is blindfolded trusts this person that at the end of this small journey, I'm going to reach where I'm supposed to be. Back to last, what I'm talking about, this God we always pray to, this God that we always know, wants you to trust him the way this friend trusted the other one for direction. The friend did not have the other person to lead him, then automatically she could not reach the place she was expected to. The person or the friend trusted the partner. The same way, we also need to trust God. That is why today I want to look at trusting in God. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus, but to trust and obey. I'm only interested in trust. With obedience, we'll look at it later. So what happens when you trust in God? When we trust in God, you become so strong. Remember, I said trust is believing in something you cannot see, especially in this scenario. Who has ever seen God? We've never seen God, but we trust him. So what happens? Because we've seen people, we saw people during the biblical times trusting God and they made it. Who are we? We also need to trust God. You back at home there trust in God. And what happens when you trust in God? When we trust in God, children, we become so strong. We become so strong. Why strong? God gives us strength. God gives us strength to move on. As long as you are trusting him, he gives you strength. And we also will become strong and feel protected. We feel protected. That is the secret behind trusting in God. Just dare him. You will be so strong even if you are so weak. Maybe you felt like, this sickness has finished me. I'm done. But the Lord strengthens you if you do what? You trust in Him that you will get healed. You trust in Him, the same way you'll be protected. Remember, always have temptations around us. Temptations can come in form of human beings, they can come in form of other things. But if you trust in God, believe me, you get so protected. We also remain strong whenever we are faced with challenges. That is what I'm saying. A challenge can be so big. A challenge can be in form of a very deadly disease like now. But I believe at this moment when you are making your prayer there back at home, you always engage God. You trust in Him. So what am I saying? That whenever we trust in God, we remain strong whenever we are faced with challenges. We remain strong whenever we are faced with challenges. Whenever we are faced with challenges. It doesn't mean that God will remove the challenge, but God will make you strong so that you overcome the challenge. Only if you trust in God. We trust God when we tell Him everything that affects us through something. What do you think is this something I'm talking about? Most of the time, if we want to talk to God, we always reach Him through prayer. And that is why I'm saying that when we trust in God, we tell Him all the challenges. We tell Him all the challenges through prayer. What is prayer? Prayer is having communication with God. That is what I'm saying, that if you trust in God, all your challenges, you will overcome all your challenges. And how do you overcome them? The answers will be given to you through prayer. So children, today's lesson is very short and very brief. It's all about trusting God. After you've trusted all the members I gave you or I told you, after you've trusted all of them, above all, let us trust God. I'll send some few questions for you to attempt. Just attempt and send them for marking. Enjoy your day.